And joining us now from Berlin, Germany, the foreign minister of Germany, Guido Westerwelle. Mr. Minister, thanks very much for coming in.
Thank you for inviting me.
Let's talk about U.S.-German relations right now, specifically the allegations that the United States was eavesdropping on the phone conversations of the German Chancellor Angela Merkel. She said, we need trust. Spying among friends is never acceptable. True change is necessary. What would you like the United States, President Obama, to do about this current controversy right now?
I think it would be the right gesture if Washington would send a delegation to Berlin and to the other capitals here in Europe, because we cannot ignore that this was a breach of trust. And we have now to consider how we can restore this confidence and this trust between our countries and, of course, our governments.
Do you know how long the United States was monitoring her cell phone, Angela Merkel's cell phone, how long that surveillance was going on?
I do not want to speculate about these facts. I can only tell you that this is a very delicate and sensitive issue for my country. We went through a very difficult history, especially when we think about the GDR and what we call the Stasi. So these surveillance activities in Germany is really a breach of trust and is really something which is discussed in our public opinions in a very serious and intensive way, not only in the parliament and in among the political leaders. So we are not naive. We know that we all have to fight against terrorism, but you cannot fight against terrorism by tapping the chancellor's cell phone.
And you have no doubt that the U.S. was tapping the chancellor's cell phone. On that subject, you're 100% sure that they were.
What we heard is enough, and we think it is now to consider how we can restore the confidence, because we think this eavesdropping of other governments or of millions of people is not acceptable among friends. We belong to the same community of values. We belong to the Western communities, and this Western community is founded on common values, and therefore it is decisive.
Foreign Minister, I've spoken to U.S. intelligence officials, and they make the point that if the U.S. were doing all of this, and they acknowledge the U.S. was doing it, it was being done to fight terrorism and to help your country, the people of Germany, as well as the people of the United States. Do you buy that?
We are grateful for the collaboration between our governments and especially between our intelligence agencies. But please, we don't think that it is fighting terrorism by spying on our government or by tapping the chancellor's cell phone. So we are not naive, but when I say we are not naive, it's in both directions. On the one hand, we are not naive because we know it is necessary to fight against terrorism, but we are not naive also that we know by tapping the chancellor's cell phone, you will not find terrorist activities. I mean, that's for sure.
Your interior minister has raised the possibility that you might expel certain U.S. diplomats as a result of what has been going on. Is that, in fact, something you are considering right now?
No, we are not discussing this kind of measures. And we think that our friendship is deep, and we think it's a not only a partnership, we think it's a real friendship.
Has Germany conducted espionage activities on the United States?
I cannot repeat what the head of our intelligence agency said in a very frank and clear way. He said that the United States of America, the government in the United States of America, are not a subject of any intelligence activities of my country.
Bottom line, Minister, do you trust President Obama?
We had an excellent discussion about civil rights and about privacy and freedom on the occasion of his very successful visit here in Berlin. So I think it's now time to restore and to rebuild this confidence between our countries. And this is now our goal, and it is also our duty, what we have as political leaders on both sides of the Atlantic. This is necessary and this is urgent, and I think we shouldn't underestimate how serious this discussion is in Europe.
It sounds to me like that answer suggests you do not, at least right now, fully trust President Obama.
I trust President Obama, but please, I cannot tell you what your intelligence agencies are doing, and I do not know what kind of reports they are giving to the president and to his team.
One final question before I let you go, Minister. There's this report in Italy that the U.S. was also eavesdropping the head surveillance on the Vatican. Do you believe that?
I don't know it. I cannot exclude it. And probably everything is possible.